Hello everybody, welcome back. My name is Mathis, and today I want to show you a really cool Kubernetes controller called Reloader. If you are currently running Kubernetes in production, odds are you've heard this before, you've probably used this before. If you haven't, then this is the perfect video for you to watch because I will explain all about how it works. So Reloader is a controller that looks at deployments, daemon sets, replica sets, you name it, that have config maps and secrets attached to it. And it will reload, as the name implies, those deployments if the config maps or secrets attached to that deployment change, right? And you might be asking, why would you want that? Well, if I have a secret that contains a password or a database connection string or an SSH key, for example, if you change that secret, it's kind of implied that you want the pod consuming that secret to be updated to use the new information in that secret, right? Surprisingly, that is not a default Kubernetes behavior, even though that kind of seems a little logical, but it's not. Thankfully, Reloader solves that problem. So I will put this GitHub link in the description down below if you want to read more. We'll go over it fairly briefly. Reloader is maintained and I think was started by Stakator, which is a Swedish Kubernetes hosting company. I'm not 100% sure. But all you need to do to use Reloader is install it using Helm, and I'll show you how to do that, and add this annotation to it. And that's all you need to do. At that point, if your deployment has that annotation, it will automatically restart if a config map or secret changes. So I have two examples prepared, and we'll see these right here. One example where we have a config map that's attached to a deployment, and another example where we have a secret, a database connection string, and this is sort of a little more of a real world example, a database connection string attached to another deployment with a custom app. But before we go into these, let us first install Reloader into our Kubernetes cluster. Let me pull up a terminal here. Let me make this a little bigger. All right. All we need to do here first is add this repository to our Helm, and I've already done this, so it'll skip it. Then we need to update the repository. I'm not sure if this is gonna do it. And there we go. And then the last thing we wanna do is Helm install Reloader, pointing to the Reloader namespace. Obviously this namespace doesn't exist in my cluster, so we're gonna create this namespace, and then we point to the Helm chart. You can also put this kind of anywhere. Kube system would be a good spot for this if you have a custom namespace for operators, whatever. I just like to put it in the Reloader namespace. So let's pull up our terminal and install that. Oh, I put in an extra slash like that. And it should take about a second. If we then go look at the pods in the Reloader namespace, we'll see that it is running. All right, awesome. So let us take a look at the first example. The first example is a fairly simple deployment here where we just have a deployment with three replicas that is running the Reloader example one image. I'll show you this in a minute. And we have an environment variable from this config map. This config map is also fairly simple. All it contains is a key value of hello and YouTube. Then actually, let's take a look at the Golang application. This GitHub repository will probably be in the description, so if you want to take a look at it, go ahead, but you don't need to know Golang in order to follow the rest of the tutorial. All this Golang code does is it prints the environment variable hello, and then its value, and then it sleeps 1 second and just restarts it. So it'll just be like a loop of logs, essentially. So let's deploy this, and let's go into our example one. And then do k apply dash f all the YAMLs, right? And that will deploy this in our default namespace. So if we do k get pods, we'll see that these containers are creating. Let's take a look at our config map. And there we go. So if we wait for these to come up, they're up. We can look at the logs and you'll see that based on our data here, it should print hello YouTube. So let's take a look at that. Let's use the dash F to follow. And there you go. So it is just printing out hello YouTube. Now, If I were to change this config map to hello world, nothing is going to happen to these containers, right? Let's apply this config map, configmap.yaml. And we can see that if we watch our pods, none of them will be restarted because we haven't applied the Staccator annotation. So the only way for us to kind of get the new value in this config map is by reloading our pods. We'll try that manually just for shits and giggles. So we'll do k rollout restart deploy sample app. And there we go. And we'll see our pods get restarted. We'll actually take a look at the logs of this one, right? This is the newest one. And that should say hello world. And it does. Now that that works, let us enable this annotation, change our config map, and see that the deployment automatically gets reloaded. So let's go into our deployment. And as you can see, I've already written out this annotation. All I need to do is uncomment it. Now we are going to apply this deployment, apply-f deployment.yaml. And then we can change our config map to, let's say, hello Mathis. And if we apply this config map, and as you can see, we're just changing the config map here. We're not modifying the deployment or anything. You'll see that the deployment automatically gets restarted. So we'll do kget pods. And as you can see here, 5 seconds ago, it created this new container. And we can do klogs-f to see the logs. And as you can see, it says hello Mathis. So this works great. Let us take a look at the second example, which is a little bit more of a real-world example. In this case, we also have a deployment with the reloader annotation commented out. And this one is running the reloader example 2 container, which is this code, and we'll take a look at this in a minute. It also has an environment variable, but this time from a secret. Let's take a look at the code. So this code is a little more complicated. In here, we're essentially taking the connection string environment variable. With that string, we're opening up a Postgres connection. And then all we're doing is selecting the ID, the name, and the age from the table users, printing that out, and just sleeping for 3 seconds and repeating that over and over and over again. Let us deploy this real quick. We'll go out of the example one, and we'll go into example two. And we'll do k apply-f to apply both resources. And we'll see get pods. And it is creating the container. We will get the logs of the top container. And as you can see, it is printing out the users in our table, Lauren, Emma, Charlotte, and Monica. Let's take a look at the secret. And just for your reference, this secret is a Base64 encoded Postgres connection string. So I know it kind of looks very similar at the start, but I can assure you towards the middle, it's completely different. These are two separate databases of two different connection strings. I know that you know that if I change this and I apply the secret, nothing is going to happen simply because we don't have this annotation uncommented, right? So let's do that. Then apply that deployment.yaml. And now the deployment has the annotation in it. That way, if I change this, right, if I apply this secret, the secret will change. Reloader will see that the secret has changed and it will restart the deployment. So let's actually give that a go. k apply-f secret.yaml. And then we will do kget pods. And we will see that, yep, this sample database app container is in fact reloading or creating a new one. We can do klogs-f. And then hopefully we should see some other names in there because again, it's using another database. So let's see. And there we go. Instead of, I don't remember the names, Lauren, Emma, whatever, we have Peter, Joe, Mike, and James. So as you can see, this works magically. And it is sort of a fairly simple addition to your deployment. If you have the operator installed, which as you saw too, is incredibly simple, all it takes to have this functionality, which I feel like should be part of vanilla Kubernetes, is a simple annotation. Now, obviously, This is an open source project, so you can go way, way, way more in depth. You can make it so that it only reloads for config maps or only reloads for certain secrets, or you can do a whole bunch of stuff with this. I'm not gonna go too in depth. Feel free to check this out. Like I said earlier, this GitHub repository will be in the description, as well as the code to these examples. And that's it for this video. If you like this video, don't forget to leave a like. If you have any other operators you want me to check out, feel free to leave them in the description down below and I will try to get to them. If you want to see more content like this, feel free to subscribe and I will see you next time.